Welcome back. As Raytheon Missile Systems marks 60 years in Tucson, they're celebrating the past and focusing on the future.
Tonight, how Raytheon is developing the weapons of tomorrow. Sandy Rathman taking us now where no reporter has gone before.
Here at Raytheon, the engineers really get into their work. Literally, put on these glasses and come with me inside their virtual workshop.
Eight of them overlapped, and they're not supposed to be like that.
This is an advanced visualization system. It allows us to view our products, our facilities, in stereoscopic 3D. Go to that problem area, Greg.
We had some serious wiring issues.
Go through that thermostat housing.
Here, engineers immerse themselves inside their products. Yeah. They say it's so much better than designing at a desk.
We can have a team in here. They can sketch things out on a napkin, and we can draw it really fast here, get a 3D geometric representation, and start looking at it and say, nope, I don't like this, and we go back and change it on the fly, real time.
Raytheon is turning science fiction into science reality, like a death ray.
Like the Phalanx close-in weapon system uses bullets to shoot down bad guy missiles, we're starting to use lasers for that.
And Raytheon is developing a way to pull the plug on the bad guys.
And if you remember from the Ocean's 11 movie, where the guys rolled up their van and they turned the lights off in the Bellagio by using this pinch, and it's a big electromagnetic pulse, and it goes in and it just shuts off all the electricity. So they're coming to a battlefield near you soon.
For 60 years, Raytheon has been on the cutting edge, and folks here promise lots of surprises in the future from some of the brightest minds in Tucson. At Raytheon, Sandy Rathman, News for Tucson.
That's a good look.
Something cool stuff out there.
Get a pair of those for us, don't you think?
Stepping into the future. Yeah, I like it.
All right, stick around, though.